So we actually organized this press conference because we submitted a letter to the BO Board of Investment to consider the 30% salary increase for the workers who works in factories which are come under BOI purview. Every year BOI is introducing salary revision for the employees who are working in the BOI factories who are come under BOI purview. The last year we had a discussion with the earlier Director General of BOI, Mr. Dambika Perera. As a result of our discussion with Mr. Bafil Rajapaksa, the senior advisor to the president, and when we discussed with Mr. Dambika Perera, he agreed to issue a circular recommending 15% salary increase for the employees who are working factories on which are come under BOI. The 15% salary increase to the salaries, the basic salary workers were drawn in December 2009. But unfortunately, Mr. Dambika Perera did not issue that circular which he promised. And then when we contacted and asked him, then he said, the issue a circular is going to be violation of the regulation of the election. And he promised that immediately after the presidential election, he will issue the circular. But after the election, Mr. Dambika Perera is no more there. Then we expect that the new Director General will take corrective action. And that is why we jointly signed a letter, the organization who belonged to ALARM, and requested the new Director General to increase 30% salary increase, because from 2010 to 2011, there is a high cost of living. According to the Statistics Department, the Colombo Consumer Index for the 2010 September, the point is 220 and 7%. So according to the Statistics Department, the 1 point is value 180 rupees. That means the family who is having 4 members, they need 39,000 rupees per month to live. But the workers who are working in the free trade zones and the factories come under BOI, they are getting their minimum salary is 7,950 rupees. So how can they live? Because they are the breadwinners of this, their family. So that is why we demanded the 30% salary increase. But unfortunately today we heard that without discussing with the unions who represent the workers of the BOI factories and only discuss with the employers, the BOI has issued a circular by increasing 500 rupees salary from January 2011. As unions and organizations who are belong to the ALARM, we condemn this action of the BOI, and we have no other alternate but to mobilize the workers who are working in the BOI factories against the BOI action, which is totally violation of the principle of ILO Convention 144, which is the tripartisan. The BOI must act, take decision by discussing with not only employers but also the workers and trade union. So therefore we are going to raise this issue with the workers who are working in the BOI factories, and at the same time we expect that the forthcoming budget, the government will introduce a salary increase of ₹2,500, which they promised during the presidential election. They promised not only for the public sector, they promised even to the private sector. So we hope that the government will introduce this 2,500 salary increase. If the government is not going to introduce, then we have no other alternate but to join hand with the public sector union as well as the workers who are working in the BOI factories and the free trade zone to organize a campaign against the BOI Act, the same time we are going to organize a campaign demanding a salary increase which can be which will be, as you know, sufficient for the workers to live, and therefore we request the government to consider this salary increase and come up with the proposal during the budget. At the same time, we request the BOI to reconsider their proposal and increase the salaries of the BOI workers, the factory workers who are working in the BOI factory, and considering our request, that is to 30% salary increase for the workers who are working in the BOI factory. Thank you very much.